So this is St. Helen Road, and we come from there. At the end is, if I'm not mistaken, is the mosque, the Oman mosque. There is a mezquita, de Oman, Omar, sorry. At the entrance, in that corner right there, you're supposed to, you can see part of Golgotha. So the stone where Jesus was, where the cross was put for Jesus to be crucified. I understand that this doesn't look in perspective, because the account in the Bible, it says that it's supposed to be like a mountain. Yo sé que no se ve muy bien, pero ese supuestamente era un pico de montaña, pequeño, no mucho, no muy grande, como una cima, una lomita a lo mejor. Pero supuestamente ese, ahí, ¿no?, donde estaba la roca mayor, donde pusieron la cruz de Jesús. Y hay un montón, no hay tanta gente como lo normal. Normalmente acá esto sería completamente lleno de gente en un día sin COVID. So there is no many people today. That is because COVID, basically. There's people, there are more people than last week, but it's supposed to be way, it's supposed to be normally this class will be full of people coming and going, but as you see, there's no many. This is the entrance to the sea. There is a door, they have locks, sometimes they close it, especially when people from different areas start fighting. So this is the stairs to bring you to what is really known as Golgotha, or the mountain. Jesus cross was closed, no Jesus cross. Esta es la escalera que nos lleva hacia la, al Golgotha, donde la cruz de Jesús se puso para ser crucificado. Arriba uno puede ver por un vidrio en la base de la roca. Ahora vamos a ascender. We are ascending to Calvary. Vamos a ascender a lo que es el Calvario. Acá sí se puede apreciar la base donde la cruz fue puesta. La cruz donde Jesús fue crucificado, ¿no? these mosaics are basically the Passion of the Christ. Representing, as I said before. Descendemos, vamos a ver un poco de la iglesia. Las siete denominaciones que toman cuidado de este lugar. Cada uno son diferentes maneras de practicar. Algunos son parte de la iglesia del este, otra parte del oeste. Cada rituales son diferentes, pero en todos ellos el centro es Jesús. Después de haber sido crucificado, esta es la tumba, ¿no? Que sigue vacía, porque él vive. Entonces, por eso es que la pray for Jesus was placed. Oh, actually, this was marked that. We always know the tomb is empty, so there is nobody because he was risen. So here it is. Vamos a encontrar algunos agujeros donde antiguamente la gente ponía los cuerpos de los difuntos, ¿no? Here in the back is fine and this this room that belongs to a first century so here are the holes where normally put the bodies to decay, and after a year, as a tradition, they will place it in a osuario, sorry, ossuary. Entonces aquí en esos agujeros donde antiguamente, prácticamente una práctica de la primera centuria, donde se ponían los cuerpos para que se descomponga, y después de un año, ellos venían y recogían los huesos
para ponerlos en usuarios, ¿no? Pues la gente le llama, esta es la tumba de José de Arimatías, pero esta es la forma donde, como se normalmente en ese tiempo se ponían los muertos.
And this is in the back, so here is yes, in the back of the for the tomb of Jesus, where they used to put there. So here. Este es el exterior de la capilla, en, dentro de la iglesia, cerrados en púlpito, que le pertenece a la iglesia católica. This is the chapel that belonged to the Catholic Church. Inside of the Holy Sepulchre, as you see, it's beautiful. Tienen bastante cuidado, they take care of it. This is one of las iglesias, uno de los denominaciones que pertenecen, que viven, que están dentro de la el sepulcro, la iglesia del sepulcro, es el sepulcro, maravilloso. Esta es otra de las capillas que se pueden observar dentro de la del Santo Sepulcro, es una de chapel. Where you can find here in the Holy Sepulchre Church, as I mentioned before, because of Corona, the entities, tourists, have killed many people. So that's the reason we can find an empty space. And actually, I have been hearing a lot of fever, so there's a lot of local tourism. Most of them are Jewish, I think, but they come to see and respect. Entonces aquí, como estoy aguantando, hay pocos turistas en este momento porque no hay todo corriendo, ¿no? Esto es uno de los pasillos, ¿no? Vamos a ir visitando. We're going to visit a few more places here in the Holy Sepulchre. Scriptures are written in Armenian. Algunas de las escrituras están escritas en armenio, ¿no? Vamos a bajar a la capilla. estos las capillas. If you don't mistake, which you don't draw in your buses, and the locals are one of the locals who is a secret. Nuestros mosaicos representan parte del Evangelio. This is of the time of the Crusaders, the painting in the rocks. This was carved.
يعني سنت
base de la montaña que corresponde al Calvario. This is the base of the mountain that belongs to the Calvary. Bedrock. So you see there is the bedrock and where Calvary was. This you see is there is a lot of smaller chapels. Inside of the Holy Sepulchre. En las afueras tenemos otra capilla, que es, si me equivoco, es una capilla de los cópticos, gente cóptica, cristianos cópticos de, normalmente de Egipto. The Coptic from Egypt. Basically, they're based in Egypt. But here, they have been here for generations. Now we're going to the basically the roof. That is basically where the Coptic Church, Christian Coptic Church, they meet. A little ceremony here. Que se sigue siendo parte de la iglesia, es como being part of the church. So here is the Queen Helen Church, Coptic Orthodox. as you have seen, it's a tricky part of the church. There is more to see, but sometimes it's closed, this place closed in other parts. And when you can see for yourself. Some of the parts that I came normally is normally not explored. So, I hope you have enjoyed this. Espero que hayan disfrutado. Este es la iglesia de San Sepulcro. Espero que ustedes puedan venir y tomar experiencia acá.